Kelley, the biggest takeaway from Budget 2024 was that it was all about capital gains. However, the Liberal government has said that it is for younger Canadians. Let's get into that.
Yeah, definitely. This was a budget that was aimed towards them, Larysa. We know that housing is on the hearts and minds of so many young people, millennials, Gen Zs. Most of them that I've talked to just feel resigned. So Minister Freeland has committed multi-billion dollars towards housing for, not specifically for young folks, but definitely to alleviate some of their concerns. And a lot of that being paid for by the rich. So individuals, corporations, trusts that receive in excess of $250,000 a year in capital gains taxes. So I think, Larysa, it's really important to kind of identify who these rich are, especially when we see the ultra rich not paying their fair share. I think to put a face to these individuals, there was an article a couple of days ago about a group of physicians of 35,000 of them on Facebook and saying how this will impact them. If it's physicians, if it's lawyers, if it's a mechanic, anyone who owns a business that doesn't have, let's say, a pension or benefits or mat leave, this is how they build their security. So how does this affect them? And definitely hearing a lot from those voices in the community, I can speak anecdotally that two of my nieces have already left the country, one a physician and one a surgeon, to Australia, where they work less, they get paid more, they have a superannuation. So I think we have to, maybe put a face to what the government is saying is the rich and how they're going to pay for this and how this actually does, when will this help millennials and does it help them?
Let's get into that. Does it help them? Do you think this will close that generation gap financially? Do you think they'll get to see that real benefit?
That's the question. I mean, a lot of the criticism has been what the Trudeau government announced back in 2017 to support younger folks for housing. We've seen anything but. Will some of these measures actually increase the demand for housing? It's going to be up to the millennials, Gen Zs, and their children, and maybe their children's children to pay for all of this spending. So maybe appealing to some of that short-term pain, but will it actually help them in the long term? I guess that remains to be seen.
Let's get into some of those measures that were announced in the budget. And I guess the weeks leading up to the budget, you had mentioned housing. What's in it?
I think the two biggest standouts are extending out the amortization to 30 years and increasing the first-time home buyer's provision that you're able to take out of your RRSP up to $60,000. And Larysa, to your point of your interview a couple of days ago with CIBC's Jamie Gollenbeck, is this kind of pandering to present bias, right, Larysa? Like where it's like getting people into a home, but with the deleterious effects of affecting their long-term, retirement and being able to retire. So it's great strategy for people that do want to get into the housing market, but how will this affect their long-term retirement if it's all about, getting that home?
One of the elements that the government had introduced in the federal budget was making that rental payment reflected as part of your credit score. How important is that?
Yeah, now this is not new. Renters have for a while been able to record and have that recorded on the credit bureaus. It's very important for renters, Larysa, because, a mortgage payment can be a large amount. That's usually something that people pay on time. They may pay credit cards a little bit later, things of that sort. But all of this adds to your credit score. And the richer your credit report is with, let's say, a mortgage payment, a credit card payment, a cell phone payment, things of that sort, that adds to your score as well. So if you have been a renter and you are a renter, not having that good payment history reported on your score certainly can affect your credit score. So that's, would love to see more of that for renters to help increase their score.
The government had mentioned everyday costs, those extra fees, everything from, I guess, capping those NSF fees to transparency when it comes to buying those Taylor Swift concert tickets.
Yeah, I love seeing the NSF fees come down, especially so looking at usually they're around $45 for them coming down to $10, and especially the multiple NSF fees. So perhaps your bank charging it, the, you know, whatever didn't go through, if it was your laptop lease or your cell phone payment or what have you, and those multiple payments. So that definitely helps people who are struggling as well to cap those. The Taylor Swift tickets and any type of ticketing. Yes, the government said that they were going to crack down on fraudulent resellers and bots. I suppose good news, again, looking at was this really a budget for young folks? I think it's a silly provision myself. Larysa, when just about 2 million people visited food banks last year, 1 in 3 of those were children. So I would have liked to see a little bit more of help for those that are really struggling, as opposed to some of these, you know, I think it's an interesting one, but I think a little bit of a silly one.